Hey everyone, Corvus here. Welcome to this video, which is all about Warhammer Age of Sigmar Dominion. So the latest box set by Games Workshop. Again, they did a fantastic job creating this absolutely fantastic set. So I have a bit of a rough outline in my head what this video is going to be about. So first I want to compare this a bit with the previous version. I have part of the previous box here, so the cardboard of the box, and then also the rules manual. So I just basically want to compare the two, quickly check some of the differences between the two boxes, and then I'm going to explain my plans with this set. I'm going to approach it and just in general give my opinion on this. So this is not going to be a detailed review video or a detailed unboxing video. This is just, like I said, quickly a comparison between this version and the previous, and then I'm going to talk a bit about how I'm going to approach this set hobby-wise. Before we continue, I would like to remind you that this box set is still available. And if you want to buy it at a nice discount, I urge you to follow the link in the video description. It will take you to Element Games website, where you can buy this set 15% off. And as an extra bonus, you can use the code GER959 during checkout for double store credit. So you basically get another discount on your next purchase at Element Games. So first of all, when I received this set, the first thing that I noticed was immediately the size and also the weight of the box. The weight, of course, is coming from the full-size rulebook, which is included in this one, but also the size of the box. This is at least a centimeter taller than the Warhammer 40k Indomitus set, but I also have here the previous, it's the shell of the original box. I still have it, so we can compare the size of this, and also have this insert box, which contained the sprues. They did it a bit different this time with the current set, but by using this we can compare the size of the box. Just the size of the outside is the same, but it's basically the thickness of the box, the height of the box basically, and I think the Soul Wars box, I think it's a bit similar to the Indomitus set. So basically this box is 1 centimeter taller, and also why I took that out of the cupboard, this fell down. So this is basically your basic standard ruler, which usually ships with those starter sets. Now that's one thing they didn't do with Dominion, so there are no rulers or no dice included. So it might be a good time to flip over the box and check what they say here about the contents. So it says 360 page book, quick start manual of 24 pages, 14 cards, and then 60 miniatures. And then on the previous version, here it is, this book contains 320 page booklet, so the rulebook, I mean. So the rulebook has grown with 40 pages. There's an 8 page start here, 16 page core rules, something that the other one does not have, and then an introduction booklet of 32 pages, and this one includes 52 miniatures. But that's basically because this one has a bit less rank and file miniatures. So basically there are 20 of these chain rasps in there. So the other one also has 20 of these rank and file goblins. So the other one basically has a bit more miniatures. And here we have basically every army has a centerpiece or this mounted figure here. And then this Knight of Shrouds here. So I think with the Dominion set, you get a bit more miniatures and more eye-catching miniatures in this box. One thing that I did not look up is the price. I'll have to check that afterwards. So again, it's similar, having a centerpiece model for every army here. So that basically quick comparison. Oh yeah, the two rule books, but I think stuff that was on the back of the box already helped us, that this new rule book has 40 additional pages. But basically they're roughly similar in style. But what I do like is the cover art on this one. Just no lettering, no logos whatsoever, just full-size artwork. I like that a lot. And then here it simply says core book, and it's very similar to this one. So this will be very nice to add to the book collection. But what I think is nicer with the second edition one is just having this logo here. And also the back of this one is very minimalistic. And this one looks like, your Warhammer Age of Sigmar leaflet basically. But it does have this nice gloss effect on there. So we can put these manuals aside and then check inside. So yesterday I've been started working on the Dominion set, basically setting aside the sprues that I want to do first, and then the ones that I actually am not planning on painting. I decided to go for the Stormcast Eternals because I painted all the Stormcast Eternals of the previous two starter sets, and I like these new ones a lot, so I would like to add them to my collection. But I was never really a Greenskins fan, so I decided on not painting the bulk of the goblin figures which are in this set. So what you will see here are some sprues that I clipped off and packaged up, and I will eventually be selling this in the near future. If you're interested in picking up these sprues, let me know via message, we can work something out. So basically these are the 10 gut rippers, some of the bigger rank and file miniatures, and then this bulk of 20 smaller goblins, which I'm not really planning on painting. Then some other ones, this man skewer, bold boys, the three of them, so the ones with the crossbows, I think. What we have here is the killer boss and the stab grot, also not quite a big fan of that sculpt, so leave that out. And then the last one is the merc knob with Belchabanas. That basically means what I plan on painting from the goblin side of this set is killer boss on great gnash hoof. That's really an awesome model. I really want to paint that one. And then the other killer boss with the smaller guy, that's the one you saw in one of those Ziploc bags. But these two figures, these two sculpts, really like them. This is the Swamp Color Shaman, fantastic sculpt. The guy with the banner, also packaged him. So basically the banner guy, and then these 10 figures, and then the 20 smaller ones. They are going to be up for sale, probably eBay or local secondhand website. But there are some very nice goblin sculpts that I really want to paint, especially the mounted guy. So it's also going to be a nice mix from painting those Stormcast Eternals, which are also quite nice, I think. Not really studied the sprues so far, but especially the centerpiece model. Also noticed there are two of these banners on the sprues. That's something I did notice. Also no sculpted bases this time. So this is the taller model, Indrasta, the Celestial Spear. So pretty awesome model. So what I did notice, what I said in the beginning, is that there are just the bases here on the side. There are no dice here, no rulers this time. This is basically your quick start guide, and then of course the cards. So then these are the sprues that I am going to paint and the bases that go with them. So yeah, like I said, I'm not going to show all this in much detail, but pretty awesome sprues. It's not a big leap in quality like they did with the last couple of sets, but I think this is your regular quality that we're having from GW in the last few years. And this is the big ore guy. Oh yeah, pretty fantastic model. So yeah, plenty of work. That's basically my plan with the Dominion set, and I'm first going to, as soon as possible, assemble everything, probably in the coming weeks. Then I have a small backlog of Warhammer Indomitus that I still need to complete. I'm probably going to try to finish painting the Space Marines from the Indomitus set before I start painting this. But of course I have the Necron faction also, so I'll probably be mixing in those projects. And also there's probably another Infinity commission coming. The client is going to send me some models this week even, so I'll have to probably prioritize that before I can continue working on the other ones. So that's all for this video. Remember to check the links in the video description if you want to buy Warhammer Age of Sigmar Dominion set with 15% off. And please let me know if you're also working on this fantastic set. And if you like the video, please press the thumbs up button. It really helps out the video and the channel. And please consider becoming a subscriber if you haven't done so already. So that's all for this video. Hope you have a great rest of the day and see you in the next one. Bye.